All right, I have to confess, despite my round shape, I love the gym. Love, love, love the gym. But I hate the treadmill. For some reason, it just makes me think of an assembly line, which is probably a poor analogy, but given my limited technical knowledge, I'm just gonna go with it. In 1917, Henry Ford set about building his legendary River Rouge plant. It revolutionized the auto industry because it had everything he needed to build his Model T in one place. As you can imagine, all of that equipment together had to be assembled, had to be repaired on the spot. Enter the Millwright. Many of us, myself included, don't know what these people do, but these jacks of all trades are actually responsible for keeping many of the industries around us, well, working. I'm Monica Rogers, and today we're going into Lee College's Millwright and Machinist program to find out how the college trains these individuals and gets them workforce ready. If you walk into the Millwright and Machinery classes at Lee College, you'd see a lot of gadgets. Seriously, this place is packed with gears, grinders, and a lot of other stuff that I don't know anything about. Seeing all this, your question might be the same as mine. What in the world does a millwright or machinist do?
They're there for rotating equipment, to tear it down, fix it, put it back together as best as just like it come from the factory or better.
This is Jack Baker. He's Lee College's lead millwright instructor. Jack has decades of field experience and agreed to show us his program.
This is the exact kind of pump that they will be working on out in the fields. This is what we're supposed to do.
If you think the equipment here looks a little industrial, you'd be right. Millwrights often work in power plants, factories, mills, and the construction industry. However, millwrighting does require significant attention to detail.
It's imperative that people further their education, because this is a science, this is not a pet thing.
And that seems to be the sentiment of many employers.
You gotta have the certificate, the college behind you, and your NCCR to go anywhere to better yourself.
Many workplaces now require potential millwrights to have certification from the National Center for Construction Education and Research. Because of the industrial nature of millwrighting, this certification proves to employers that a millwright knows the fundamentals of his field as well as safety procedures.
Because the last thing you want to do is go out there and create a big catastrophe. Because I don't want to be around when you do.
We had a chance to see the level of precision involved in this line of work.
And if you punched enter and then jog over one, and it tells you how many thousandths of an inch that you would be out of.
That is ridiculously precise. That's insane.
See that red dot? These students are using a laser to optically align this machinery.
Oh, wow.
This has got a little refraction mirror in there, comes in and tells this computer what you need to do to move that the way that it needs to move. We're working in thousandths of an inch here.
Along with precision comes payment. According to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, the average salary of a millwright is more than $50,000.
They can start out at $16 to $18 an hour, and by the time they've got a couple of years under their belt, they're up to $23, $24, $25 an hour.
That's a good living.
That's a good living.
A full-time student can get millwright and machinery certificates in 5 semesters or a year and a half.
It helps you learn exactly what the plants are anticipating when you go.
Robert Hodges is a former student who went through Lee College's program. For him, the education coupled with experience made quite the difference on the job.
I went from a field hand to lead man to supervisor. And I'm trying to knock my boss out of his job.
If you were talking to someone who was, you know, a little bit younger, you know, maybe a high school student who's really looking to get into a job where they're really working with their hands, what would you tell them?
So I suggest you go to school, you learn what you're supposed to learn, at least the basics of it, and then you move on into your field. I mean, they actually do good teaching here, and you actually take back what you learn to apply in the field. And that's why this program right here is so important.
So what does a millwright do? Everything, apparently. From supervising construction procedures, to building foundations, to completing emergency repairs in the dead of night, to even working on assembly lines and piping systems responsible for the delicious treat that I'm about to enjoy. These guys keep industry in our area moving. And with the right education and training, they can earn a pretty good living doing it. I'm Monica Rogers, and if you'd like to learn more about this or any other program we offer at Lee College, be sure to check out our website at www.lee.edu and tune into our YouTube channel for more episodes.